Hey everybody, it's Amy Astro here, and I have a project for you guys today. It is going to be a DIY field flattener. A couple weeks ago, I showed you the entry level one using a tracing panel. Then I showed you a more advanced one using the Flatmaster. Now I'm going to show you an intermediate one that you can build for yourself for about $60, $65. So stay tuned. This video comes to you from a fellow viewer who, when I was discussing flat panels and all the different kinds there were, he shared with me over email what he's done. And it was really quite clever, and it was inexpensive and easy to do that. Well, I was in the mood to build something, so let's get started building something, okay? First, I had to go purchase a kit. And this kit was about $50, $55 shipped to me. And it was from Illumiglow, okay? It's illumiglow.com if you're curious. Now, what this kit had in it was a nice little light panel. Hard to believe, it's super flat. And the panel kit came with its own little controller, which as you can see here, it's operated by a 9-volt battery. It has a couple light settings on here. It has a scroll bar for bright to dark. It also has a flashing mode. So it's one of those toggle switches where you turn it on and it starts flashing, you know, blinking lights. And then you press it again and it'll go to a nice steady light. And then you adjust the dimness level to your liking. But what a gentleman named Bill Schlein pointed out to me, that this was really flimsy and it needed another way to mount it to your telescope that would be something really easy to move around, sturdy and all that. And he came with some clever ideas. And you know, I love an idea that takes me to Home Depot, to Walmart, to the arts and crafts store, anything. It even sent me up to my attic to pull out some old things that I had. But his idea was, plug in the battery here just so it's out of my way, and it comes with a nice little cover that I think I left in the house. But he sent me to Home Depot to get one of these, and this is one of those grid plates that you use when you're draining water in your backyard, and it connects to another hose, you know, I guess for like French drains or anything. Now his was awesome in black. Well, mine is Master's green, but you can get black ones. It just wasn't on the shelf for me. Now this happens to be a 6-inch round grate in the fancy color of green, and this one is an 8-inch grate in the nice color black. But if you look at the two on the inside, you'll notice they are the same size. The black one that I found on the shelf is actually a reducer. So if you want one that's bigger and bulkier, you can use this, but it's the same circumference, you know, of the circle. But what was really cool was the kit came with this, and I haven't taken the cover off. It's a piece of frosted glass, plexiglass, and I took this to Home Depot with me, and what I wanted was to find something that would fit that piece of plexiglass. And of course, Bill made it real easy. He told me what aisle to go to. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with exposing this piece of plexiglass here. As you can see, it's a nice little opaque. It's not clear, but we also want to make sure we don't scratch it up because we know how soft plexiglass can be. All right, now that I've got it off there, nice clear. There's no stray lines in it. You know, you should always check it and make sure there's not already a pattern built into this because we don't want that. And what we're going to do is I'm going to unplug the control box. The yellow side is the side that lights up. And we're going to take the controller part, and you'd like to think I could get it through one of these holes, but ultimately I'm going to drill myself a hole here on the side and fish this cable through. But I'm going to show you guys the concept. You push this in here, this cable will come out the side, We're going to take the opaque panel and drop it on top, okay? Real easy. Now, but all of this will easily fall out. So his next clever idea was to go to Dollar General, or in my case, I went up to the attic and found some Hot Wheels track. Now, my kids would probably shoot me if I cut this up. This is like one of our best memories, you know, of the boys growing up, was these things lined up. I can't tell you how many hundreds of yards I had of this, going up and down a hill and seeing if we could crash the cars and land them in a basket. Lots of fun. But what I did have was one of these sewing rings here. I used to do a lot of needlepoint, and I don't need this one anymore, but even if you were to go buy it, they're like a dollar if you get these little cheap plastic ones. And this one, it is too big. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut a section out of here, and since this is very bendable, I'm gonna use it like a spring clamp that will hold everything inside. So I've got myself a little hacksaw blade, and I am going to sew this. I'm gonna cut this first, and let's see how we can do this and not lose a finger. This is probably not the sharpest hacksaw blade. All right, cut number one. Let's see. Oh yeah, that's gonna work good, but I'm gonna take a little chunk out of this, okay? Let's try about that much. There we go. So now I have a gap, and if I cut enough of it, which I did not, I need to cut another, let's say, centimeter to centimeter and a half out of here. So why not? We need the exercise. That looks good enough. This is like filing my nails here. There we go. Now my gap's like that, and I can should be able to pinch it closed. And, oh, that's just perfect, guys. There you go. So there I have it. And now it's not going to come out. And what's really cool about this is the fact that I can dim this on my own. The button is a little quirky, so if you can find yourself a controller somewhere else, by all means, investigate that option. And all I'm going to do now is drill a hole in the side, fish this cable out, and bring the cable up here, and then we are going to probably... Let's see, it comes with this clip on here, but I don't think I need that clip. So, oh, don't tell anyone. I'm probably going to break this clip off. Nope. Well, I'll break this off later. But what I'm going to do is double side Velcro it up on here, plug it in, unplug it when I'm not using it. But let's show you what it looks like. All right, right now you can see that it's in blink mode, and I turned the brightness up just so you can see it. And I'm going to press the button one more time and get it to go steady. I think, did I turn it off? All right, there it is steady. Now this does have a humming frequency type sound, but since there's no dummy light on here, I guess we'll use that sound as a way to know that it's on. It's on fairly bright right now, and I'm gonna dial it down. And as I dial it down, you can hear the humming goes down with it. But what's really nice about this, is this is the perfect size for a 60 millimeter, 80 millimeter telescope. And it fits right over the end and hangs just the way we want it. Now, unfortunately, this is too small for my 102 telescope. I mean, I needed it to be about a half a centimeter wider in diameter. I could probably shave enough out of the inside of this to make it work if I wanted to. If you didn't want to use this green grating type thing, you can always just take it out. This fits perfectly inside the nose piece of my telescope and it works great. Now, I did take some flats with this. I compared them to the Flatmaster and really, they were equal. I used the same time, I looked at them and they looked great. It just took me a few minutes to dial in what was the brightness setting, but really, once you set it, you forget it, and that's it. So that's what I have for you for a DIY project. Real simple. This piece was about $5 at Home Depot, then $55 for the kit that came with the flat panel, the piece of plexiglass. It came with the controller for it, and yeah, that's it. It was a good deal, and I ordered it on Monday, and I had it like by Thursday, which was even better. Now, you can go direct from the manufacturer, which is, let's see if I can read it through here, it's Technolite, and they sell this panel for a little bit less money, but they do not include the controller with it. So you decide which way you want to go. I used the folks at alumaglow.com and got it, and they sent me a great set of instructions on how to hook it up, how to get everything up and running. And this kit was specifically made for us astrophotographers. So really, you don't get any better than that. Well, folks, that's what I've got for you guys today. Thank you for hanging out with me. It looks like it got dark while I was sitting here. It's going to be a great night out. Too many clouds, but I've got plenty of images I need to start processing, and I'm really looking forward to that. So if you guys like these type of videos, please consider subscribing, hit the thumbs up, give me a grand old like. I appreciate every one of them. Leave me comments down below if you have any other ideas or things that you would like me to show you in future videos. I love DIY projects, especially if they're inexpensive and very useful. And I'll tell you what, I can almost bet you when I go out to the star field and I use this next time, everybody's going to want to know how I did that. So thank you so much, Bill, for sharing this with me. I appreciate this. I appreciate all of you all. So stay tuned until next week. That's when I'll see you in the next video. And until then, I love each and every one of y'all. Goodbye, y'all.